In this section, we're going to talk about linear regression, which is the idea of evaluating a linear relationship between two different numerical variables. So to start off with just looking at what graphs look like for this section, we're going to look at scatter plots. And to start off with our scatter plots, what we're going to need is data. So on the left-hand side here, here is our data. And what you'll notice is we have two columns of data. So way at the beginning of this course, when we looked at making histograms and dot plots and calculating mean, standard deviation, all of that was in terms of a single numerical variable. Now what we have here in this section is two numerical variables. And how that's going to come through is we're going to have two columns of data. But what's going to happen is these two columns of data are going to relate to each other, in that they're going to both be collected from the same thing or the same time, things like that. So in this data below, we have temperature and chirps per second. So the idea being with this first value of 89 as the temperature and then 20 as the chirps per second for these crickets, those two values are linked together. That's from a single recording from a moment in time where it was 89 degrees Fahrenheit outside and they recorded 20 chirps per second. So those two values are stuck together. So we can't really rearrange these columns of data. They would have to be connected, and that 89 should always go with 20. Oh, you can see different readings with different values. Like down here, you'll see an 83 with a 16, but then also an 83 at 17. And that's completely fine here. What it just represents is they collected data at two different times. At both times, it was 80 degrees Fahrenheit outside, and it's just one time they recorded 16 chirps per second, the other time they recorded 17 chirps per second. So with this, we get two values out. And how these values are going to work is exactly like in algebra, where we're going to have x and y coordinates. So we're going to have an x-axis and a y-axis. One thing we have to think about, though, is which would represent x and which would represent y. So if you remember from algebra, x is considered our independent variable. So it just kind of works on its own. There isn't really anything changing it. And then y is considered the dependent variable. So with that, we kind of think about what do we expect for dependence here, which kind of operates on its own, and then which could be responding to the other variable. So we could do is try out the different wording. Is it temperature that responds to chirps per second, which would be the equivalent of saying like, oh, the crickets are chirping 16 times per second. It has to be 83 degrees outside, which probably isn't the order in which it works of what happens first. Instead, if we said chirps per second depend on the temperature outside, that's a more likely outcome. If we are seeing a relationship, it would probably be the temperature outside changes how the crickets are behaving. So with that, temperature is going to be independent. And things like temperature and time, those are most commonly independent because they operate in their own way. So temperature is going to be x, and chirps per second is going to be y. And what we can do is make a graph of these values where we're going to get these coordinates. So we're going to draw a dot for each of these different values using this x and y coordinate. So for setting up our axes, once you determine which is your independent and which is your dependent variable, you'll set up your axes. So because temperature is x, that goes along our horizontal axis, and because chirps per second is y, that goes along our vertical axis. Setting up the number line for temperature, I skipped ahead to 65 because our lowest temperature that we'll see is 69 degrees. And then just remember, if you're skipping over any units, you need to use that kind of squiggle to say there's no data on that side, so we're bumping up to 65 degrees. Similar for chirps per second, I set the minimum at 13, so just to skip up to 13 to say nothing's happening between 0 and 13. So we can really zoom in on our data because we want to see a clear picture of the behavior. So making the scatter plot, I started with making the axes and the number lines, and then it's a matter of plotting these dots. So it's a scatter plot because you're going to get this scatter of dots coming through. So you're not going to connect them like we would in algebra, like we won't connect them with a line or a polynomial or anything like that. We want to see these as individual dots because they are these individual data values. So for example, this coordinate 89, 20, what I did is I went to where temperature is 89, and then I have an output of 20. Oops, where am I? 89, 20. And that gave me this coordinate right here. Then 93, 20, went over to 93, up to 20, and it gave me that coordinate right there. So what I did is making this scatter plot is I plotted a dot using these x and y coordinates. Now the scatter plot, what we're going to want to, what we'll want to do and what we're going to talk about in the next video is looking at the trend that comes through. And with this section being all about linear regression, what we want to see is a roughly linear trend coming through. Rarely is it going to be perfectly linear, but like this scenario is showing a pretty nice increasing line of data. So this is going to be something we'll look for and that we'll want to describe in terms of how much does it look like a line and what direction is it going in. But in terms of right now with temperature and chirps per second, we could see there is some relationship. The fact that I can even imagine a line going through tells me there's a relationship between the two variables. But when we describe this relationship, we want to be very careful of what words we use. So, is an increased number of chirps per second caused by an increase in temperature? Now, if we look at the data, we see this increasing trend. As temperature is going up, as we have higher and higher temperatures, the chirps per second are increasing as well. But that's just a trend. We don't necessarily know that temperature is the cause here. It could be something else that's occurring. So this word cause, we want to be very careful using anything that implies causation. There's anything saying cause and effect. So basically, when it asks for cause and effect, no. If you remember what we talked about at the very beginning of the term and implying causation, we had to have a really well-designed experiment in order to do that. We had to have an experiment with a control and a treatment group and placebo. It was once we designed all of that that we could say cause and effect. But here, we're just collecting data. This is observational data. Basically, we rarely want to say anything with cause and effect. So, no, we can't claim causation. And why this is with observational data, there can be these lurking variables. So we don't really know what's making the crickets chirp more. Maybe it is the temperature. When it's warmer, they get more talkative. Or maybe it's something else that when it's warmer outside, something else is occurring. There's some other variable at play that's actually causing the crickets to chirp more. So we don't know if it's actually temperature itself. What happens in general, now this is the kind of wording we like for these questions, is talking about what's happening in general. We can say, like, claim about trend, or there's an overall relationship. We basically want to use looser wording to get through this idea that there is this relationship of increasing temperature and increasing chirps per second. We just can't say one is causing the other. So this implies kind of good wording here. If we just say in general, chirps per second tends to increase with temperature. So getting in some good wording of what happens in general, and this wording of tends to just say this kind of trend that we see and not necessarily one thing causing the other. So some pieces here. Up above, we talked about independent and dependent variables. When we work with correlation and regression, we like to use terminology of response variable and explanatory variable. So like how we talked about that chirps per second will tend to change based on temperature, is that chirps per second tend to respond to temperature. So that's why y becomes the response variable. So that would be our chirps per second. because that's what's actually responding. And then the explanatory variable, the variable that could explain the change that's happening, it's coming from temperature in this case. So any questions with response and explanatory variables? It does relate to dependent and independent variables and X and Y in the end. And then this last piece is just to emphasize that we want to avoid talking about cause and effect, but we can talk about predictions here. We can start predicting values based on the trend that we're seeing. So that's a little introduction to making scatter plots within on a graph based on data. What we'll do is we'll see how to make these in GeoGebra as well in a future video when we start talking about correlation, so that we can kind of quickly see the trend that comes through without making these graphs by hand.